Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everybody. Mike Verta. So I talk a lot about transcription. This is mostly
morning,
for musicians,
good afternoon,
but
good
not.
Evening,
and
everybody,
I know
Mike Verta.
This is a consternation to people because
if
you look
a lot
at my
about
videos,
transcription.
This is mostly a music channel,
this
right?
Is morning,
for musicians,
good
but not. And then
everybody,
I know this is 100
Mike
views,
Verta.
This is a and then I noticed the one that I posted, the Uncle Bourbon one, gets 2,000 views. So clearly, people don't really give that much of a shit about the music. They just want to hear me blather on, and that's without Miss Love. I think when Miss Love comes to the Uncle Bourbon show, those views are going to go way up, but it's just me being humble. Listen, it's still a music channel primarily, so I'm going to, just because that's what I post, but I'm going to talk about transcription today, live transcription. I'm going to do some transcriptions for you. And the reason I'm going to do that is because I talk about it all the time, and I will tell you, if you've heard me say to transcribe more than once, and you haven't done it, you're just being a dick to yourself. You're just making your life harder. Transcription is literally what I do to relax. Like just music, I want to do music stuff, but there's no stress in it. First of all, there's no stress in it because it's not for anything. Second of all, you're listening to good music, hopefully, and then at the third part of it, you learn how to play a song. It's all good. But when you start, you should start easy stuff. And my favorite easy stuff to go to is 80s music, because that's what I grew up in. It's good, and it's actually really great. It's better than 50s or 60s music, because 50s or 60s music is like so 1-4-5. It is so one. It's just all the... Okay, yes, you can learn all the Little Richard and all this. Mostly it's the same tune. 80s has a really, really diverse range of chord progressions, more than the sounds. And in fact, today I'm just gonna randomly grab stuff from my Spotify playlist. But it's just your vocabulary can go way up, but yet it's not hard. And the trick to doing transcriptions, I'll show you a couple of tricks, but also one of the things that happens is, even though there's this diverse set of chord progressions or harmonies that you can use, a lot of things repeat. There's a lot of patterns that repeat. And you begin to learn how to transcribe simply because you recognize a pattern. Like if I said, ladies and gentlemen, you don't know what the second word is because I didn't say it really, but you do. You know it's ladies and gentlemen. You didn't hear it. When you first start, somebody might say, well, I think it's ladies and gentlemen. No, it's not ladies and gentlemen. If anything, it would be gentlemen and ladies, but it's not. It's not ladies and gentlemen, it's ladies and gentlemen. Well, how do you know? Because it's always that. It's a common saying, ladies and gentlemen. So if all you get is ladies and gentlemen, he said ladies and gentlemen. He just swallowed it. And you know that. How do you know that? Because I've heard it 100 fucking billion times. It's exactly the same with transcribing. And so you'll see a part of the process as we do it where it's like, okay, I can't really hear it. I'm assuming this is the case. I can't really hear it, but I know what it's going to be. It's either this or it's maybe this. But it's going to be one of the two because it's always that. It's never ladies and gentlemen. It sounds like ladies and gentlemen. It's not. It's ladies and gentlemen. It's a common saying. It's exactly how it is. So this is what I do. I'm just literally going to do it for you. I'm just going to transcribe some 80s tunes. And I've done this before, but not live. So if you want to ask any questions about the process while we do it, feel free. And again, no set things. If there's an 80s tune that I have in my playlist and you want me to transcribe it, just shout it out and let me know. But I'm just going to pick a tune. I don't know what tune. And I'll show you what my process is for doing 80s tunes. And then I put the keyboard up here because then if nothing else, you can learn how to play these tunes. Let's do that. Let's start. And you know what, though? I have to put on the headphones. Well, I mean, of course you have to put on headphones, right? But I have the in-ear ones that don't look so bad, but I can't find it's COVID shit. I can't find my fucking, I think it's in Florida, Mike, so I have to use these fucking things, whatever. I said, oh, wow, I can hear myself. That's great. Okay, let's see here. Let's start with a tune here. What do we got here? Let me just scroll through. Not the best one. Maybe it's a good one. Peter Gabriel, Sledgehammer. Michael Jackson? Okay, we'll do Michael Jackson next. Let me see if I have any Michael Jackson in the playlist. I have Man in the Mirror. Want to start with that one? We can start with Man in the Mirror. Let's start with Man in the Mirror. Then we'll do Sledgehammer. Sledgehammer might be a good one to do. But let's start with, actually, yeah, let's do Man in the Mirror. Okay, here's Man in the Mirror, right? I don't hear it. Do you hear it? I don't hear it. Let me see how we can get this to come up. Also, oh yeah, I don't think we have the, let me see if I can get the audio to come up here. It's really not playing. Man in the Mirror, that's a good tune. Actually, as I think about it, that's going to be a great tune because, let's see, Man in the Mirror, that's a good tune. Ooh. Actually, as I think about it, okay, hold on. You know what? Technically, I have to figure out how. I just realized I had not set up for playing back a thing. So how am I going to actually do that so that it doesn't loop and blow up the audio? We don't want to do that. See how I'm going to do that. You know what? Let me take a break. Just technically work that out. But this we're going to do. So get ready. When I come back, we're going to do live transcriptions. And so make a list here of, I'll just like pause this for a second or whatever. Make a list of any tunes you want me to do, and then we'll do it. Sorry, I didn't think. Technically, I don't actually have a way of. Listen, what if I use my phone? Can I do that? Let me try that. Let's see if that'll work. Just like, technically, let's try something here. Because this would be really cool if this worked. Just plug this into the phone. Then we don't have to stop. Man in the Mirror. I can tell you already, as I'm thinking about that, that's a tune that does exactly what we're talking about, which is it uses a very, very, very common descending progression. I don't know which exactly which progression it is, but I will in a moment. Let's see if this works. Let's go to my Spotify. And this also guarantees that this video probably will not be online because if we're playing all these tunes, you can just pretty much guarantee that YouTube's going to shut all that shit down. But, you know, let's see here. Man in the Mirror. I remember that one. Let's see if this works. Let me just play a tune for a second. Okay, that's not it, but that's gonna work. Okay, so let's find Man in the Mirror. I'm sure I have that, right? Yeah, I did have it. I just saw it. It's a Michael Jackson tune, which is probably written by Quincy. Sharp-Dressed Man. That's what we should do. I'm just looking at these other tunes, like Material Girl. That would be a good one to do. These tunes. Because there's always something in it. Here we go. Let's see what this is. Okay, so the very first thing I was going to say is that usually I go by bass notes first, because so often the bass is the fucking root of the chord. Like this, your first thing is find the first bass note and then just assume it's a major chord. You're already like 50%. So, but this one starts with this thing. It sounds like, let's see. Okay, there's a rhythm. I think this is what Michael Jackson does. Got it. Okay. Something like that. Something like that. And I'll tell you what that is already. Yep. Okay, so already I can tell you that it is not a remarkable ear by which I was able to work that out. This is a very common descending pattern. Or it could be. It's essentially what it is. It could be a lot of, there's a couple of variations, but. That's in a million tunes. That's 100 fucking billion tunes. So this tune is already not an original tune in any way. It's already just treading stuff that's been done a million times. So in this case, it's really the production and the start in the beginning that's making it like in any way different. But that's how I was able to do that, is I could sort of tell, oh, it's going to be this. And like I said, there's a couple of variations. There could be a few things. It could be the E minor, or it could be the C. It's one of the two. Or probably the And when they outlined this thing, that tells you it's this kind of tune. It's the ninth. He did. So it's, and that tells me language-wise, ninths are going to be a part of this, which it would anyway, because 80s ballad type stuff always had a lot of the ninth in it. It wasn't just major chords. It's going to have the ninths. So knowing that about tunes just means that as I'm going for chords, it's worth it for me to consider suspensions or ninths, because it's already all over the opening. You see what I'm saying? So a lot of precedent is already telling me how to do this tune.
Good, gonna make a difference, gonna make it right. As I turn up the collar on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind?
So again, I can tell you what that's gonna be. It's gonna be again, because that's always what it is. I can tell you it's gonna go, and then probably, because that progression super common, and this could be or. It's a 5. It's going to be a 5-1. We know this is in the key of G. So this ascending pattern, very common. Or with the 7th. Or there's like 4 variations, 5 variations of that exact same thing. And so when you're transcribing, you're like, oh, we're doing the ascending one. It's either this one or that one or this one. It's just like on a car. You know what I mean? It's either the windshield wiper is here, or it's over here, or it's the one. It's one of the couple. You know what it's going to be. So it's the same sort of thing. Is there a name for such a progression? I don't know. It's just a descending progression. It's like a scalar. Tunes that use this descending stuff. So we also know we're in G. All right, so we're in. This is my playing Nostradamus. It's gonna go. And then it's gonna be. Because it's in G. Let's hear.
A broken bottle top and one and four.
Oh, back down. Which one was it? Which one was it?
The man in the mirror, I know where to go. That's the one I know.
It was this one. just thinking how the melody of the. Ooh, there's a thing in there. Okay, we'll fix that in a second. Okay, so again, also super, super, super common. There's nothing original about this tune. Still a good tune, right? In fact, that's one of the things. That's part of why people like it. Okay, this thing, also super common. Tons of blues, R&B stuff, use that all the time. Super common. Now I'm also learning something about the composer. I'm kind of telling, I can tell what he's doing. Like I can kind of tell, oh, okay. I can tell what language, what idiom he's working in. It's got some gospel stuff in it, right? It's got some gospel in it. So if it's a word, if it's a chord, if it's something that I'm not 100% sure of, I should probably lean toward something in the proper idiom. But we've already broken the back of this tune, right? We already know what this, whoops, we already know. Put yourself and make a change. Oh my gosh, right. They follow each other on the wind. By the way, this could have also been. That would also be very common. All right, so let's hear what. No messes gonna bend and come up to A7. If you wanna make the world a better place, take a look at yourself, then so, make a. Okay, interesting. Normally this would be this, but you can hear. Gives it a little more bite. Best way to think of this simply is a C sus 4 over D. There's a way to write this in D as a D, but just think of it this way. So you could have just, he could have just gone standard, but it's a little dirtier, it's a little sexier. Same thing. Same thing again. Oh, well, oh, deep in the sky, somebody's broken heart, and washed out the V. Back down to the V. They follow the pattern of the wind to sea. They got the pace to beat. That's why I'm starting with me. I'm starting with the man in the mirror. I'm asking him to change his ways. We are 3 minutes into the tune, man. We're more than halfway. And so this tune is, you know, you're already, you could almost play this right now. You know what I mean? This is very, very simple. And you can slow it down if you need to. The program I use when I need to slow it down is Transcribe. It's a great tune. It's a great application for slowing it down if you need to find these things out. And that's what you could do is just work out. Because if you just found the bass notes, which you can do by rolling off the highs too and boosting the bass, but if you just went and you were like, well, I have no, that's a very common. You'd be 9/10 of the way there if you just went with the majors, major chord, and you'd sense that that was wrong, but that's until you learn this trick. So my point is, this is actually very, very simple, such that it's pretty much done for you once you just get those basics down. Let's hear what else there is, though, because we're only halfway through this tune, so there must be other stuff coming. But it repeats, like a lot of stuff, right? So that's good. Let's see here. Yes, you can play tons of tunes. This is tons of tunes. There's like a million tunes that this is. The mirror, I'm asking them to change his ways. And no, my sign, get the best and a keeper. If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and make the change. Starting with the man in the mirror. Okay. Okay, so that's a brute force modulation. Somebody says, when's the next Uncle Bourbon show? Yeah, I know. Everybody wants to know Uncle Bourbon's coming back. Don't worry. Don't worry. I just don't want to do it without Miss Love. And Miss Love's in Florida, so we're just trying to figure out if maybe she could come in remotely or something. Anyway, so we're... And then they just go... But you know it's going to be the exact same thing, one half step up. And then we're going to do, I'm sure, the same thing. There it is. Sorry. All right, let's hear it. By the way, there's little stuff going on in the bass. Little stuff which you can work that out. That's like second tier is like all the little bass stuff that's going on. It's important just to get the. Ooh. He's holding on that E flat. One second. Okay, that's gonna be a couple things. Again, I'm gonna guess it based on this tension, this dissonant tension, which I use all the time. So, and it's either, or it's either that, or it's just a straight B major. But it would be. So it's gonna be one of those. How do I know? Because it's always that, man. It's always that. I can't quite hear it. The piano was way up here in a second ago. But I can't really hear it. There's a lot of shit going on. Except I just know that it's going to be that because it's always that. And this thing is something that comes in time. Just because I've transcribed so much that I keep coming across this stuff. So I am trading on a lifetime of transcriptions to do this transcription. Regardless, when you start learning this vocabulary, in the beginning you might not get it right. But I also want you to see that nothing I'm doing is very sophisticated. And nothing that they're doing is very sophisticated. This is really probably what it is. Let's check. Yep. Go. not a genius. This happens. This is a very common way to handle this. So when they're sitting there on this, and I know something about the age of the guy who's writing it and what era he grew up in based on that. The identity of the composer is all over the arrangement. So it's either, like I said, if I was going to really do this, I'd figure out exactly which. It's either a straight B major, or it's, which is what I do, it's sexier. I think this is it for the tune, too. Like all that bass shit that's going on, you can work that out. Not important in the beginning. So same descending pattern as the beginning. Right, isn't it do something like that at some point? Something like that, or just maybe D. Let's see, I hit near something like that coming. Flat sus too. It's just Michael Jackson doing his thing. Very, very, very simple tune. And at least in this case, for me, it was things that I've heard a million times. This, very common. And this one. Very common things. Just put together. This one little thing was a little different, but very common. Okay. But again, nothing super, there's really just major chords here mostly and a couple of other things. Could I please do a Béla Bartók music for strings first movement? Yeah, I will transcribe that. No, seriously, when you start 80s tunes like this are great because they're simple. I was originally going to grab a Peter Gabriel tune. It was... because it's not typically something... Let's listen. It's Sledgehammer. Oh, yeah. Oh, right. It starts with a sample from... Right. That's a sample from this keyboard. That was a sample on, like, one of the emulator keyboards. It was a patch. Right, it's going to be like a pentatonic. That's a pentatonic sound. Which, again, something you learn to recognize. And a lot of those flutes kind of have... Was it called the Enigma sample? Was it called? Something like that. It's going to be something like that. It's hard to hear. Which, again, you can work out all day, but we know it's getting... What we're learning from this is the key. We just want to know the key. So I think what happened is they probably heard the sample, the Emu to Shakuhachi sample. It's just a patch. This was a little like, that's cool. And they used it to write the tune. but this also lets us know. So, what else we got? So we're eight, so bass notes. So I'll start with bass notes. And of course it's going to be D flat because we've established a pentatonic thing. It's not going to be D major because there's a D flat. Logic. It's just logic. Well, that's hard to hear. Major. Now it's major. All right, interesting. That's what it is. Again, descending, very common. Largely still staying in that pentatonic. But he went major here. Okay, so now another thing, this little ascending bass thing. It's something like, now in bass lines, this is very, very common. And there's, again, just like with the descending line, there's like 10 different versions of it. There's, and there's, or, that's Ghostbusters. Or I Want a New Drug. Very common. This is, so it's gonna be one of these. Or it's gonna be, I know it already. So which one is it? Let's hear. He went from major, from minor to major. Two of them. We need an unusual one, actually. Something like that. It's a little hard because the bass is sliding a lot. It's a little, it's sliding, but if only you got was a portion of that. If only God was a portion of that, then at least you know we're gonna, it's gonna be, because he's outlining no matter what the next note is. He's outlining an E flat chord, so it already tells you something about the chord. So let's hear what else we got. Have a steam train. If you don't stay. We got a bass part. Now, there's a lot of stuff going on in a Peter Gabriel tune. The next thing I'm listening for is anything to confirm exactly which chords are going on in this piece, because I've got, he's mostly doing that. Let's just say that that's the bass idea. What's going on chords-wise? Let me hear. There's an organ thing. Not yet, I don't hear it. Top. If you bring your sky back, hear it? Back, all you do, hear it? Little organ thing up in there. Okay. Alright, so. I could hear that on the top in the organ part. Well, it makes sense. It's E flat major, and that's the third of E flat, so it's probably. Now, we know he stays in E flat, so the question is, what's the next chord? I know which one it is, but you could, you know it's going to have F in it. So you could try F. No. You try B flat. That's got an F in it. No, that's also a tune. What else has got an F in it? D flat. That's it. Guarantee you that's what it is. It's the only other option, really. Down to C. All you do is call me. You just go through the, how about C major? No. Try, assume it's the root. Assume the bass note is the root. No. So. All right, that's where he goes. Same thing. We already got a minute and 30 of this tune killed. Going up and down all around the bends. You could have a thunder car bumping. There's amusement in the lens. He's going to do the same. Oh, no. Again, bass notes. Okay. So we're into the melody. Start with major. To start with major chords, no. There it is, C minor. And then try major. Nope, try minor. In pop music, major and then minor. It's going to be exactly the same thing. Already got the melody, got the thing. Very simple tune. We already got, so we got this tune already. But an important thing is that we can work out all the individual parts and we can do all those little pieces, but it's infinitely easier to do those pieces when there's a context around them, a chord and bass context, because they're going to follow that somehow. You know what I'm saying? Let's see here. So we're going back to minor, just like the beginning, which you already know. minor. So you've already done this part of the tune. You've already done this. The beginning. Anything else in this tune? That's the out of the tune. So very simple tune. Start with that minor, then it's got two other parts, and that's it. That's the whole tune. So is this what you mean when differentiating between the essence of a piece and the reduction of a piece? For sure, because this is the essence of the piece. If you wanted to block out what the chords are for this piece, I mean, this is... This is Sledgehammer. This is the tune. It's missing a million parts, but it's fucking Sledgehammer. You can't miss it. Okay? And so and so any tune you can reduce with, even with all this production, you can reduce to to its essence, and those are the chords of it. Now, yes, we could go back and we could get all those little pieces, we could get them, but it's much easier to do that once we know what the chords are going to be. And again, super cool tune, really simple. These are all really simple, and it gets increasingly simple based on your knowledge of these familiar patterns. So again, half of what you're hearing is my ear, and half of what you're hearing is, oh, I know what that's going to be, because it's always that, because none of it is original. Which I hope also helps put a little kibosh on the whole idea of it all has to be original. No, it doesn't. You have fucking Omar Hakim playing drums for you. Don't worry about being original. Just let the groove happen. Speaking of grooves and Omar Hakim, next one I just see is Material Girl by Madonna, which I think I mentioned earlier, which I've never played this tune. I don't know. Let's hear what... First bass. Something in there that's hard to hear. Okay. Ear training. We go back. Ear training. That's, hold on, loosely. There's stuff that's hard to hear because it's low. It's a low octave something. Okay, that first thing. Ear training. I happen to know the sound of that interval. It's a dominant seventh. It's Star Trek. Then probably. I just know that because I know that interval. Just when you do any kind of interval training, you know, a fifth is Star Wars. You know, a fourth is Here Comes the Bride. You know, and a dominant seventh is Star Trek. You just know that. So again, you know, if somebody said, what is that? Without, I don't really have to play it. I know what it's going to be. It's also told me something else, which is that this tune is not afraid of a fucking dominant seventh. Because it's a little bit, of course, with doing this little bouncy thing. Somebody says, I'm not an educated musician, so I have holes in my music theory. This isn't really theory. I have no idea what you mean with five of one. Scale degrees in relation to the chords. Just major scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Common chord progressions are 1, 4, 5. That's a major chord built on the first note, the fourth note, the fifth note of the major scale. If that's all you knew, you'd be halfway there. Somebody always thought of fourth as Skywalker's theme. Oh, yeah. Sure. Anyway, so let's hear what else Madonna's got for us. Material Girl. Makes sense. We've already established that dominant seventh, so he's building a very cute. So So we know that in general, that tonality is going to be all over this tune. Bass notes first. Remember, it's super simple. So, we've already established that we're basically in C major. And this progression, there's another very common progression. Or, in this case, also very common. And it's one of two versions, just like in Man with the Mirror. It's either the F with an, that's the third in the bass, or it's the root of an A minor. It's one of the two. It's either an A minor built on an A, or it's an F, and that's the third of the F. And sometimes we can make it difficult in transcription as they're so close and that you could easily hear them being right that can your brain can get in the way. In this case, I can tell you it's the A minor, but let's check. It's A minor. Two, five, one. 2-5-1, most common progression. Now, I can tell you, I'm hearing something else when that first chord happens. It's not a straight C major. Listen, I'll tell you what I'm hearing. I'm hearing an F. That's what I'm hearing. Something like that. That's what I'm hearing. It's in the keyboard part. And this? Also super common from the era. So, it's like, it's in my mind, oh, it's going to be one of those. I didn't have to find that. I could hear an F, and if I'm hearing an F, oh, they're doing this. Because that's what it would be. Yep. So. I can't hear the chords there, but I think that's what it is. I can't really hear it. It's close enough. Okay, again, super. Five, one, most common, which is also interestingly the very first tune I ever wrote when I was 6 years old was. So I guess I'm in good company. Anyway, that's it. That's it. That's the tune. You can stop right there. Some minute 30 all the time. We already got it. Pretty sure. Some boys try and some boys lie. I have to work that out. This is close enough, by far. Only boys that save their pennies make my rainy day day. Cause we are living in a material world. And I am a material girl. You know that we are living in a material world. And I am a material girl. Now. I just can't not hear it. There's a little keyboard part underneath the melody, underneath the chorus. I can hear the second part of it. It's this weird, like, keyboard. I can hear it in there, but I can't hear it. And it's going to follow the chords. Then, like. Or. It's something like that. Hear it. It's an octave lower here. That's why I can't hear it. It's a really weird sound, too. Because it's going to follow the chords. So it's outlining the chords. Okay. There's that little keyboard line underneath the melody. I can't hear it the first time, but this is pop. 9 times out of 10, it's going to be the exact same thing, an octave lower. So let's try that. It's an octave lower. It's that, an octave lower. Because of course it is. What are they going to write, 2 parts? For pop? Fuck that. So again, the little keyboard part, hard to hear, except that the notes really were given to us because we knew what the chords were. The chords were F, G, and A minor. So it wasn't going to be like some weird, it was going to be, it's just following. Really, really, really obvious, right? Is that a goat on background vocals? Yeah. It's really a weird sound. It's hard to hear. It's just that, and this is a classic example of I can't really hear it, but we know what it is. Because of course it's that. It's the fucking chords. This is all the same stuff. We've already done this. We've done all this. Anything else? That's it. That's the tune. Fade out. Whatever. So, and again, you know, people are asking, could I transcribe other stuff? Yeah, of course we could do real complicated stuff. But I'm not sure you're ready for that. You just start with this stuff. Because first of all, it's right there for you, and there's some structure to the tune, not like anything today. Don't nothing today is worth transcribing at all, zero, none. I mean, it's all like, it's one bar. It's like, as I hear tunes that through the wall sometimes, and other people playing, it's like, that's not the fucking, there's nothing. So at least here is structure. Mm-hmm. So that's 2 tunes we learned how to play. And again, you could write, and you should write this down too when you do them, just so that at least you have them memorized. But that's two tunes. And you could go back, and if you're going to try to fill out all the little other parts, and you're going to try to get the other stuff, let's see. What else we got? Find another tune. We mentioned Ghostbusters earlier. It's just a Ghostbusters. That's a really easy tune. I think I've done that before too. That's how I do it usually. That's my little trick there. Top of that. I'm sure the key's in B. Oh. Okay, I know it's in B. And this bass pattern is, we talked about it, the same from Sledgehammer. Or wasn't, but could have been. So you want a new drug? And what's the rule when you do pop stuff? Just start with a major chord. That's A. And that's it. No. That's if you're going to play the root position of those chords. But remember, keyboardists are lazy. They want to move their hands as little as possible. So the closest A and the closest E is what it's going to be. There you go. Got the bulk of the tune right there. But there's that little thing with the sax. It's a B major chord. Yeah, it's major. Why the best musicians in the world are generally not found in pop and rock stuff is because you can now play the tune basically and imagine doing this every night. You want to blow your fucking brains out. Unless the music is a means to an end, it's a means to money and pussy, then yeah, it doesn't matter what you're playing, just so long as you're getting the money and the pussy. But if you actually like are a musician, you want to play, like if you can learn to play a tune within 5 seconds, it's not, you're done already, it's over. It's not challenging, but this is what's good about it from a transcription. Don't you do it. Who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters. I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
Bass first.
I ain't afraid of no ghosts. Something weird, and it don't look good. Who you gonna call? Ghostbusters. I ain't afraid of no ghosts. I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
So we got a B minor for the B section here. So when it goes up, it's probably going to be B minor. Don't have to think. It's already B minor. It's not going to be something else. If he's going to stack it, it's just like chords. It's going to be what it is. Use your brains. We got the bulk of the tune already. So we got that little keyboard part. We got the main melody. We got the B section. We got the opening.
An invisible man sleeping in your bed. Oh, who you gonna call?
I think it's gonna be. For the tune. That tune. So really there's not much else to the tune. Very, very simple. Very simple. And again, really, 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 I mean, you'll find this is what the advantage of doing tunes like this. It had four parts, right? It had that stuff, and it had the main, and it had the, what else? So I had like four or five different little things to learn, all of them very, very simple. Okay? Let's see. Let me see a tune that would not be like a techno tune. A tune that would not be just typical for... That's a good one. I saw at least a couple that might be good to do. Let me see. I'm looking for something that's kind of weird, like that would be sort of tricky, that can illustrate something. Oh, wait, I know. Wait, hold on, give me a second here. I know I have this in here. I've played this tune before, I think. It's this tune. I can't remember what it's called, but I'll remember. Oh, here it is. Rock the Casbah. Yeah, this tune. Okay, check this out. Hold on, check this out. Okay. What a weird. How weird. Okay, all right. So, this tune, first of all, find the bass. But the other thing is, this is a classic tune where it has an idiom. The chords are all going to be of a particular family. And it's clearly not just major and minor. You can tell it doesn't have a very clear major minor sound to it. But let me work out the bass thing, because the bass is fucking crazy. At the beginning. Now there's like three keyboard parts at the top, so we have to figure out what we have to start with, just what the basic chords are. So like I said, we figured out it's D. Try D major. No, it's fine. Which makes sense now in that line, because he's playing the minor third. And we heard the bass line. Just try. No, seems like we're all in minor land. Or maybe. That's probably the essence of it. Very common. Major, minor, major, minor, major, minor. That's not right, but it's close. No. Okay. We know we're somewhere in the universe. I keep doing this. I'm hitting it's a minor seventh. I talked about this, the tonality. You hear this minor seventh? The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a seventh to all the chords. For two reasons that I'm going to explain. The first is because I think that's what's making it complicated sounding. We're already closer. That's a major seventh in case. All right, we got it. It's in there. One of the things I talk about in orchestration and in voice leading is that minimum amounts of motion are almost always the hallmark of good voice leading. And also, I talk about this a lot. When you play, look at your fingers, little minimum amounts of motion. So as I'm looking at some of these voicings for, like, here's an A minor seventh, and the next one is a G, I'm looking for the thing that if you were playing it and you were designed to make it easy, what's the minimum that you'd move your hands? And the next one we said was E minor, but we're trying E minor seventh. Where's the closest E minor seventh? And we tried a seventh, but it's not. It's major seventh, but it's all right there. Look at the groupings on your key. Do you have a keyboard? Look at the keyboard. It's going to be right there. Probably. Something like that. Could be that. Could be major seventh or... I'm not sure. So that's what's making the tonality. All right. So it's a seventh kind of thing. The chords are going to be seventh kinds. They're either going to be minor sevenths or major sevenths. Okay. It's the language of the chords in this tune. And we can guarantee, because this tune is like this, that pretty much from here on out, when we have a bass note, let's assume it's going to be a minor or major seventh. And I bet you we will be right 9 out of 10 times. We haven't even heard it yet, except that we're learning the language of the tune, just the way we did with these other tunes, the language of the tune, the composer or the performer. Let's hear it. Find out some more bass notes. I don't know if they actually tried it with the tune. Simple. So, if we don't test it, if we use detective work based on what we've done already, can we guess what these chords are going to be? Well, so we started out in D, and we know these are the bass notes. So what do we do? We start with the... Just try that. Those assume that those are the roots. That it's an A chord, an E chord, a G chord, and a D chord. Well, we know this tune is minor. We're not even going to bother going to A major. And we've decided that the language, the harmonic language of this tune, is minor sevenths, dominant sevenths, right, and major sevenths. So let's just put that in there. Let's make them all. Actually, we've been going from major to minor to major to minor. Is it major in the next one? Nope. And it's now the next one's going to be an we have an E, so let's do E minor seventh. And what's the next chord? Let's try G minor. Try major. What's the next one? D. So D minor seventh. It sounds like it, doesn't it? It's probably it. We haven't even heard it. Well, I mean, we have, but we haven't tested it. But we're using what we know about the tune. We're knowing about the language that they write the tune in. And this is how this goes. I'm almost sure that's what it is. Let's check it out. This tune mostly transcribed for us because we're paying attention. We're not looking at each chord as its own thing. I got to learn this chord, then I got to learn this chord, and then that's how people are. That's not how people write. And you can feel that the person writing this tune and they liked this sound. It sounds like they just learned how to do it. It's what it sounds like. It sounds like they just, wow, there's this thing you can add a seventh, and so the whole fucking tune is seventh. And I can just tell you, this keyboard player is not fantastic. I could just tell you that, because this whole thing, it's just, there's, it's sort of what new keyboard players do. It's like new drummers do the same thing. They just there's like a thing that they do when they start. Also, this thing, it's probably major seventh. It could be. It could be straight, but why would it be? Everything else has been major seventh, and the guy obviously is digging his sevenths. So it's probably. And if it's not, it's funky and it works, so don't worry about it. I think we just repeat it and see if there's anything else. Yeah, you can hear. But as the wind changed direction, and the temple band took fire, the crowd caught a wheel, that crazy kid on fire. Yep, same thing. Same thing. So, you're ready to take that. You can take that into concert now. You're ready to go. So, again, this is just a thing that I really want to drive home when you do these transcriptions is pay attention to what the tune is telling you about itself, because that's how you stop it from going from an infinite sea of options to, well, what's the one that's going to make most sense, and it's usually easier than you make it. And you can slow these down you can slow them down as much as you need to. You can roll off frequencies to help you, but getting the bulk of the chords is that's where it is. I mean, if we're not even doing the melody, but you know what the tune is. I mean, you know what this tune is. All you need is somebody who can sing. But you can take this into, you can play this in a concert in like 10 minutes. You'd be ready to go. So again, tune seems like it was more complicated than it is. It's really just minor chords, but they add the seventh to it. That makes it real complicated. Somebody says half the battle to tunes like these is figuring out the stupidity. That's actually really well said, because in ways you can tend to overthink it. But remember that pop music is populated by and performed by people who do not have great musical skill. It's always going to be simple. Somebody said something about Duran Duran, but I happen to have, I saw a Duran Duran tune here. Hungry Like the Wolf. Let's do that one. E. So we're in E. Just the bass note. Lots of E. D. Start there. Okay, so. So again, we just did that. It's pretty close. E and D. That's the whole tune for the melody. Now, you know. By the way, this is also very 80s and very common. We heard that in Sledgehammer. We heard that in a bunch of stuff, just leaning on the dominant seventh. Breathe. section. We're already at the B section. There's something going on in the bass. Hold on. Give me a second. So, bass notes. But then I'm hearing like a, I'm hearing it. So just try major chords. No. I think that's what it is, actually. That's what it was. It was all major chords. I told you, get the bass note, you got the chords. Major chords. Are major chords complicated? We're already a minute 30. Tune. Not hard. Major chords. There's nothing in that tune. So, again, super, super easy. And now you can play Hungry Like the Wolf. You didn't have money for seven chords. So, but again, all you need to get is that bass note. And as I said, it really, you can slow it down, and then you can also do F sus after the GCF. It might be. I'm not sure. All right, what else we got? Let's see. What else other tunes we got? For all the tunes that are simple, sometimes you can do... it is? Okay, if you say so. I don't know how you know that. Okay, certainly don't. Quote, by the way, almost all sheet music in all time is fucking wrong. It's all wrong. I've never seen a sheet music for a tune that was fucking right. But that's all right. Except the ones I do. Let's see. I mean, it could be. But I don't hear the change, actually. But whatever. It doesn't matter. That's not the tune. So even though stuff is... tunes can be made out of simple parts. You can put them together in complicated ways. And there's one that I'm thinking of that moves around. Where is this? There's one that moves around that's actually more complicated. Like it's, let's see, where is it? I've said before, I think this is the entire 80s compressed into one tune. Where is it? Let me see. A lot of tunes in here, man. Days of tunes. I'm going past all these tunes. I'm like, yeah, we could do that. Let's see. '99 Red Balloons. Yeah, that's one. That's easy. Jump. Maybe I'll just show you what the real solo is for Jump. Nobody ever gets it right. Where is Danger Zone? That's one. Back Centerfold, that's a tune. Eye of the Tiger, we'll do Eye of the Tiger. Oh, Take on Me, we'll do that one too. That's a good one. But I'm looking for one in particular. Do I not have it? It'd be really weird. Oh, here it is. El DeBarge, Who's Johnny? I don't know what this stuff in the beginning is. This is like not in the radio version. Okay. We've seen this. That progression is a billion years old. It's in a million tunes. It's very unusual. Usually when a bass pattern is set up in the beginning of a tune, then that's the one that's going to be, but they're not doing that. They're doing a variation. Why? Something like that. I think that's what it is. I think that's why they're doing it. That's weird. She says, what? There's something weird in there. It's E flat major. That's not right. Something's wrong. Oh my god. It's minor. That's crazy. That's crazy. It's minor. Yeah, that's gonna be, yeah. Crazy about that chord. She says it's always Johnny. I try to understand because I'm people too. And playing games is part of human nature. My heart's an overdrive. It's great to be alive. So, all right. So another tune where I'm going to start to rely on. Okay, this tune is fucking crazy because it'll jump around. But suspended seconds all over this fucking tune. Because that's 80s, and it's just all over this. It's not A flat, it's it's So we come to this B section. I haven't checked, but almost certainly it's going to be sus too. And then this thing can either be, or it can be, it could be either, or it can be. It's either one of those two. Again, this ascending thing, remember this from Man in the Mirror, where this was? That's all over this tune. That's like, that exact ascending pattern is like the core of so much of this tune that's coming. And again, it's one version or another. So it's... All right, let's hear where it goes from there. But again, let's listen. Descending. She said, you know I love you. Who's John? She said, and tried to look the other way. Eyes wave her away.
Oh, what?
I love you. Who's
John? She said, you could never do this. Tell they're getting back to E flat. Okay. One second. Okay. So we got our bass notes, so let's just check for majors and minors. We know it's suspension, so it's going to be that. Something like that, but let me listen to what's going on above. This is the guitar part that's going to tell us what we're supposed to do. This is a hard tune. Hear it? So, that's a top note of some chord. That makes sense. I don't know which one that is. Might just be that. Could be one of those two. To open. You know, it could just be that. Thank you. don't know about that D.
It's not an easy tune.
It's just harder than you think.
Hold on. Hold on. Jesus Christ. You could not fake through this tune. This is the hardest one by far. Okay. That's cool, actually.
Goes right back to it. But he's got a little keyboard part up there. With it.
An easy tune, even though it is really, really, really based on fucking, it's really simple, but it's just moving around. This is why I wanted to play this, because I remembered, so yeah, any little Beto, we need Dylan Beto to come here and tell us what it is. But it's, again, this is like, these are simple parts. They're just, these brute force modulations are fucking, you just can't fake your way through them. That's why it's taking me a minute. Fuck you. A very special girl. Okay. She said, and tried to look the other way. Maybe don't start with this one. Eyes gave her
away. There's a major seventh.
It's gonna be that.
Now we're in A.
Fuck you, what?
Okay, this is not fair.
Oh, this, no, that's different.
get through this tune. Okay, we got that too. Oh my fucking God. Jesus Christ. Okay. All right, so very, very, but somebody's just changing the keys in a superpower. This is true, but I never, that tune is fucking working it. That tune's working. That tune deserves respect. Christ. That, you'd have to write that down. You would have to write that down to fucking remember that. There's a lot in that tune, but it's actually still put together on a really simple fucking, wow. Okay, so respect to El DeBarge or whoever, somebody who knew what they were fucking doing behind that tune. That's not easy. We got it, but it's still, you'd have to write that down. I couldn't remember that shit. Is there something simpler for me to do the next one just to give my brain a rest? Oh, fuck, that's not cool. That's how long that took me. Sorry. That's not, yikes. Get a little cocky, throw a little El DeBarge at your action. Let's see. I didn't even know the tune was. I knew it had that shit in it. I knew it moved around. I didn't know it moved that far. I've never done that tune. Let's see. Something simple. Something easy. I'll just pull up Tom Petty. No, let's see. Oh, yeah. I Hate the Tiger. We got to do that one because that's a really popular tune. Let's see here. Oh, yeah, there you go. Nice. I love it when you get lucky like that. It's probably A or E flat. Oh, yeah. So that first, we guessed A flat. Now we know it's A flat. There's your dominant seventh. Okay, so we know the first thing. It's A flat. Let's get those bass notes. Trying major. we're close. It's not quite right. Oh. Sure. It's keyboard friendly. So it's actually D flat. It's actually, that's the actual chord. He's just building it on a third. I think so, right? Sounds right. Same thing over again. Simple chord. Let's all celebrate and have a good time. Celebration. Which, by the way, just as a moment, it's a lot of D flat, G flat, and A flat so far. That's D flat, that's G flat, and A flat. And this is G flat, D flat, and A flat. It's exactly the same three chords, just in a different, just reorganized. It's time. Oh. B section. It's up to you the time. The chord, I don't know how to tell you. That's just a particular sound. It's a major ninth. I got the bass notes. And again, I knew this next chord just because my hands aren't going to move much. That's the only way I can tell you. People don't move their hands much. Something like that. They're just lazy. Think lazy. Your party with you. Come on now. So, again, this has its own language. It's using a lot of sevenths, and it's a real black tune. Flat. Really likes their D flat. That's D flat over B flat. That's the whole tune. Pretty sure. Let's just check that out. Of course, but I'm pretty sure. Anything else in this tune? So bring your good to you. Come on. Nope. Come on. Okay, that's the whole tune. Okay, that was good. Woo! So that one's a simple tune. But again, you know, like there's just things that tell you. It was like three chords. Arranged. Except for this stuff. But that's the whole tune. All right. I'm going to do another one easy just so I can feel confident. This tune, I saw it earlier. I've been talking about doing this. This tune uses a progression that is in about 800 kabillion tunes in the 80s. Where is it? Super easy tune. You can learn this one in less than 5 minutes. I'm just sure of it. Let me find it. We did Sledgehammer, right? Oh, and Material Girl, we did that one too. Where is it? Miami Vice. No, that one I don't think we're going to do. We could, but it just would be such piecemeal. Because you'd have to learn like little bits of it. You can't really perform it. Let's see, where's this thing? Here we go. Another confidence-inspiring tune. This is so easy. It's a bass note. So if you just follow that rule, just try majors and minors. If that's all you tried, just the majors and the minors based on the bass note, it's one of two combinations will work, and you'll know immediately. Minor ninth in there. Did my time, took my chances. There's a ninth. Run the distance, now I'm back on my feet. Just a man and his will to survive. Anybody can play this tune. So many times, it happens too fast. You change your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight just to okay. Keep them alive. Right? There's nothing else. Rising up, straight to the top. And the guts got the glory. When the distance now, I'm not gonna stop. Just a man and his will to survive. It's deep, eye of the tiger. It's the thrill of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of our rival. Okay, so that's that whole tune. Nothing to it. Super, super easy. Yeah. But again, bass notes. If all that you do is work on those bass notes, and you can get the bass notes by rolling off the highs in an EQ and then slowing it down in a program like Transcribe. So, and that level of complexity is way more represented. It's, that here's Johnny shit is not, it's not usually what it's like. Let's see here. Seeing some requests, but I'm looking, there's a couple others that I saw that I was like, oh, that would be a good one to do. Because I wanted to show, too, that it doesn't matter what style it is. It's all, like, because a lot of times, you know, you hear different tunes and you think, oh, this one will have something different in it because it sounds totally different. But we've had Rock the Casbah and fucking Michael Jackson, and it's exactly the same thing. You just have to laser in on what the chords are going to be, the basic chords, and you know that they're going to be simple because it's fucking pop music. What the hell are we talking about? Like, here's a tune that you would not, like, here's a tune. Not that one.
Oh, guitar tune.
Blues lick, you can't not know that. But there's something going on that I think the chord. That's E major. I'm listening to this guitar. Top note.
Totally different type of tune, a guitar tune, a guitar heavy tune, like a ZZ Top kind of thing. Nothing to it. There. And find that bass note, and all we did was go major or minors. And this also, that's about as common a thing as you would ever. What else? Video Killed the Radio Star? By the Buggles. I don't know if I had that one. Let me see. There's a couple others that I was looking at. We'll look at some of those. Video Killed the Radio Star. Okay, we'll check that one. There's a couple others I wanted to see here. Like, I'm just looking for ones that are, you know, across a different variety of styles, just to show that they all, behind it, it's, even if it seems like it's production, oh yeah, all right, Take On Me, this one. This is just a keyboard tune. DX7 bass. We got the we have the bass note with B. So start with major and minor.
to that. That's really the same chord. It's just... those bass notes, right? So you know it's minor. You already know you're halfway there. So when you're thinking about what that keyboard part is going to be, we talk about this all the time. It's probably outlining the chords. You know the first one is B minor. So it's going to be, there it is. What's the next chord? So it's going to be E minor. You're just going to, you just know that it's, you're going to be based on that because those are the chords. Something's wrong. Hold on. I don't know what. Oh. Weird that he did that. It's weird. It's a little clam in there. But I think, it's obviously what they meant, but that's a weird choice. Well, it's just a different choice. I'm sure that's it, but it's weird. I didn't realize that. Did not know that. So again, bass notes. I don't know what to say. About earlier, that descending stuff, there it is, just in a different form. This progression is as old as Stonehenge. So, I think that's pretty much it for this tune, but let's just see if there's anything. Oh, there's one little thing. Yeah. Right? Just work that out. Tell you, that's it, majors and minors. Nothing chords. Majors and what is this? That's going on the whole time. They just faded out because it got so weird. This is quiet. It's still in there. You can hear it. So that's that whole tune. Again, really huge, big tune. Nothing to it. Let's see what else we got here. I'm just going through tunes that I like. Sorry. Let me see. What is this? No Woman, No Cry? What? Really? Really? You don't need my help with No Woman. You don't need my help with any of these, to be honest with you. Flight of the Bumblebee. Where's like some like, oh, here, let's talk about this one. This is a keyboard kind of thing. I'm assuming keyboard guys. Slow down. Bass notes. Majors and minors. Minor. That's basically, that's it, right? That's all you needed was the bass. Those are the chords. That's it. That's all we needed was the bass. And it's just majors and minors and majors. Now the only thing is that there's a keyboard part, I mean, which you have to know in order to get this right. So let's just check that out.
Just a small town.
So, just as I work this out, I hear the basic octave, and we know what the chords are. So the keyboard thing is gonna do the chords. It's just gonna be, or maybe there's no third. I don't think there's any third. It's supposed to be B flat, so it's gonna be, or it's gonna be one of those two. There's gonna be the chord, or. Simple, a keyboard player. He's not a great player. He's a fucking rock piano player, you know, and he's not a session guy. He's not one of the Picaros, you know? So it's going to be real simple. I'm pretty sure that's going to be it. Let's just check.
Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
We're morning. a minute in the tune. So, again, these keyboard parts, if you don't overthink them, if you just take the cues from the bass and the majors and the minors, like most of these tunes, you know, there's not going to be tons more in this tune. We could do it. I just want to show that this is the same process over and over and over again. And I'm finding I just find my bass note and assume over majors and minors, and that are suspensions in your, at least through 80s tunes, but it's only easier for other eras. You're getting like 4 or 5 parts that you work on a tune, and these are super fun to do. I mean, it's fun, you know, it's like there's a tune right above this here in my playlist, which I'll just do because why not? Sort of open fifths, not a lot of chords, but so like which is it? Is it major or minor?
Try them.
What's funny? There's no third, they're open fifth. They're deliberately not. Let's hear what the sax is doing, because that might give us a clue what's really going on here. Does he really go up that far? Oh, that's wild. So he's doing that for both of those lines. So if you were going to just take those notes, it's certainly closer. There's to D minor, to D flat minor. It's essentially, it's like he doesn't change the chords, essentially, because the sax isn't. Sound like some other kind of tune. Who can it be knocking at my door? Go away. Don't come out here no more. Can't you see that it's late at night? Very tired. Just descending. And I'm not feeling right. All I wish is to be alone. Stay away. Here's that guitar part. Don't you a clue. Make no sound, tiptoe across the floor. If he hears, he'll knock all day. I'll be trapped, and here I'll have to stay. I've done no harm, I keep to myself. There's nothing wrong with that. So it's not, it's really like without, there's no thirds, it's really open. So it's sort of up. This is often common power chord stuff. You know, there's no third in it. It's not really committing. So other than those little clues, if you were playing this tune, you'd have to play this open fifths. You can't be turning this into, it's not the tune. It's not. This is one of those cases where it's deliberately open fifths and you can't commit past that. The tune is it's intrinsically part of this tune. You can't. That's closer. That I can see. It's just my fantasy. I like Colin Hayes. This is closer.
follow me. It's not the future that I can see. It's just
there's something
fantasy.
Going on here. There's a thing going on here. What it isn't is it's not. Or it's not that. It's like Sesame Street. Instead of doing that, that's why you can't do that on this tune. He just did, like, what's going on is like... like, it's not... We're not really committing to the chords here. It's all, I mean, it's open fifths.
It's not the future that I can see.
Absolutely part of this sound.
It's just my fantasy.
Do this tune without this tune. Ooh, it's a... What? What? This ghosted in there. I think it's gonna be like. Let's see. I think it's gonna be this. It's ghosted. So it's one of those tunes where it's very, very simple, you gotta follow that. That's an open fifths thing. You start putting in too many thirds in there, and you miss the zeitgeist of the tunes. You got to make sure you do that. But yeah, like that. Somebody says when you add the third, it sounds weird. Yeah, it does. It's open. It's got to be open. So it's all and that open fifths is a huge thing. We heard that in the. It's just later when it... So there's a time and then there's another time. So anyway, but like the thing like sax solos like that or like little moments like that that are just so intrinsic to the tune. Somebody says sixth grade jazz saxophonist. For sure. For sure. I mean, but, you know, it's like that tune. I mean, that tune is... You can't not have that sax solo. I mean, that's fucking balls out. That's like, and go. You know what I mean? Spotlight on the dude. There's no fucking stuff behind him. He's just out in front of the audience, 50,000 people.
dee dee dee. Yeah, he's like, he's working it out. But that's an iconic sax solo for that tune. You can't notice it. That's why I had to transcribe it. But yeah, we've been doing live transcriptions just because, you know, we talk about it all the time. Talk about doing transcriptions and people don't do them. And I'm like, well, you got to do them. Anyway, I have about only a few minutes left. I got to go pick up Draco. So let me just pick one other tune here to do. But I just, the whole point of tonight was to just give you, you know, a little taste of what, you know, I do this literally for fun all the time. And it's relaxing, but it's also really, really good. What did I do here? Penny Lanes, that's easy. Let's see, what about, God, there's so many tunes I would do. We could do this some other time, it's really useful, but you know what, this video will get 3 views because it's not Uncle Bourbon. I've just already learned that. Uncle Bourbon got like 2,000 views, which is a lot for my channel. I have 12,000 subscribers, I have no idea. So 2,000 views on a video is significant in my channel. All the music I post, 400 views. Yeah, I don't really need to hear his music. So I don't even know if I'll post this. But, what about? No, that wouldn't be hard. I was gonna do Thriller, because that's like a tune that sounds more complicated than it is. Well, this wouldn't be fair to do because I know this tune, but nobody ever, ever, ever plays this tune right. This is a keyboard tune. I'll just play a second of this because I gotta go anyway. Where is it? This is where is this? The tune that made pianos cool. Where's the, there it is. It's the tune that made pianos cool. The thing about this tune is the chords are simple. But Hornsby loves Aaron Copland. So you're gonna get these Copland ninths. But this whole thing, that's all, you know, that's the tune, that's the... I wish I could remember the solo, but yeah, it's just this... It's a piano player's tune, did you hear that? All this stuff... Oh. To this. That's just, it's meaty, and then he does. That whole stuff. But the whole tune is a piano player's tune. You know what? I'll see if I can remember the solo. That's the one thing. If you do this tune, you gotta do the solo. That's the whole tune is the solo. It's been years. I don't think I can do it.
That's just the way it is. Oh, but don't you believe it?
This part, I know this part, hold on, wait.
something like that. Oh, it's killing me. Something like that. Oh, it's killing me. Remember this. You have to do this. This is worth your time just to work this out. Because it's a great solo. I want to remember this part. Your time, good great tune to transcribe, because it's actually very, very simple, and you can slow that down and pick all that stuff up. So but yeah, I remember this. That's it. This is funky, because you do a double thing. There's two, it's that thing. Anyway, so that's it for today. Thanks for joining it. And watch back if you want to, but the secrets of transcription are all here, and it's really not a thing, man. Find the bass notes, try majors and minors, and you saw that doing that alone, we'd have gotten through like 90% of today's tunes, with the exception of maybe fucking Rock the Casbah and Who's Johnny. And even Who's Johnny was fucking, you know, it's actually simple. He just brute force modulated the shit out of it. I actually really like that tune. But yeah, I learned that tune years ago. I learned the way it is forever ago. But I haven't played it in years. So anyway, so that's it. I'm going to go get my little boy and do my Sunday or whatever day this is. And so you guys now go. And now go, you transcribe a bunch of stuff. And it doesn't, people were asking for tunes. Yeah, go do Penny Lane or do whatever you're going to do. Go do those. But do them. Because I guarantee you, every second that you spend doing this is so, so, so good for you. And it's also fun. And then you also know a tune. And then so then when there's chicks over, you can be like, I know this tune or whatever. I don't know if that still works. But it worked when I was a kid. All right. you know. Hey, I could play Bloody Sunday. All right. Thanks, everybody. See you next time. You too. We'll do you too next time.